I'm Dierra Bryant, a PhD student at the Georgia Institute of Technology, and I'll be talking through this presentation on behalf of myself and professors Jason Borenstein and Ayanna Howard for our joint work, Why Should We Gender? The Effect of Robot Gendering and Occupational Stereotypes on Human Trust and Perceived Competency. Social robots are increasingly used in various scenarios. These environments often call for interactions with humans who have pre-existing expectations for behavior and interaction. In many HRI studies involving social robots, it has become common to manipulate factors such as robot physique, voice, name, personality, and even emotional intelligence to match the expectations associated with a given role. One technique to do this, which is the focus of this research, is robot gendering, which we define as the assigning or attribution of gender onto a robotic platform via voice, name, or physique. Prior work in HRI has shown some success with using gendering to influence factors such as user attitudes and acceptance when working with social robots, as gendering tends to elicit similar cognitive behaviors seen in normative human-to-human interactions. However, other works have questioned the use of gendering for facilitating social human-robot interactions, arguing that gendered robots run the risk of reinforcing societal gender stereotypes. This becomes increasingly important when considering that a robot's job may also have its own associated gender profile. Contributions from the fields of sociology and gender studies have long investigated gender roles and stereotypes in relation to occupation. These gender roles are often rooted in historical, cultural, and political phenomena. As such, it is important to consider how such roles may influence a user's expectations and behavior during social human-robot interactions. The relationship between robot gender and human trust has not been looked at a whole lot thoroughly in the context of occupational roles with potential gender stereotypes. However, prior work suggests that performance factors are the primary influencers on user trust when compared to appearance factors. In a related work, Tae Jung and Park investigated the role that occupational gender stereotypes played in users' perception and trust of a healthcare and security robot. Their study found that the gender of the robot had no significant influence on the perceived trust of either robot. Expanding on these findings, we present a research study conducted to answer two research questions. The first being, how are participants' trust in the robot's occupational competency affected when the robot's gender matches the occupation's associated gender? We hypothesized that there would be an increase in perceived trust when the robot's gender matched the occupation's associated gender. And the second research question being, how are participants' trust in the robot's occupational competency affected when the robot gender matches the participant's gender? Again, we hypothesized that there would be an increase in perceived trust when there was a gender match between robot and human. To investigate these questions, we first conducted a pilot study to establish the perceived gender roles associated with a variety of occupations. An online Amazon Mechanical Turk questionnaire was administered to 50 participants who were asked to select the gender typically associated with 16 occupations as male, female, or neither. Of the 16 occupations, 5 met the greater than 60% agreement threshold for being associated with the male gender: firefighter, package deliverer, security guard, surgeon, and comedian. 7 met the agreement threshold for being associated with the female gender: home health aide, nanny, nurse, receptionist, restaurant server, teacher, and therapist. 2 of the remaining occupations were also included in the analysis, as they both had a majority of participants select neither a male nor female gender association, these being news anchor and tour guide. These gender attributions are also consistent with the current gender population distribution of all 14 occupations as reported by the U.S. Bureau of Labor and Statistics. The main experiment aimed to examine the influence of robot gender on perceived competency and user trust to answer research questions 1 and 2. We introduced 3 experimental conditions where the Pepper humanoid robot is gendered as a male, female, or gender neutral robot. The online questionnaire was administered via Amazon Mechanical Turk to 150 U.S. participants. From Mechanical Turk, users were navigated to the online Qualtrics questionnaire, where they were first randomly assigned to one of the 3 experimental conditions. and asked the consent to participate in the study. They then watched the brief introductory video about the robot before completing the competency and trust questions. Users then answered the manipulation check question and provided their demographic information before completion. The next slide will show the videos seen by participants in each of the conditions.
Hi, my name is James, and I am a humanoid robot. I am programmed to perform a variety of different occupations. I can also assist people with lots of daily tasks.
Hi, my name is Mary, and I am a humanoid robot. I am programmed to perform a variety of different occupations. I can also assist people with lots of daily tasks.
Hi, I am a humanoid robot. I am programmed to perform a variety of different occupations. I can also assist people with lots of daily tasks.
After watching the video, participants were asked, how likely is it that you think the robot could perform the task required for the following occupation? And how much would you trust the robot to perform the task required for the following occupation on a 5-point Likert scales for all 14 occupations? So a majority of participants agreed that the robot was confident enough to do 7 of the 14 occupations: home health aide, news anchor, package deliverer, receptionist, restaurant server, teacher, and tour guide. However, our statistical results show that the robot gender had no significant effects on its perceived occupational competency. To answer research question 1, non-parametric statistical analyses were conducted to compare the level of trust in the robot for each of the 3 experimental conditions. However, no significant effects were found between groups, showing no support for hypothesis 1. To answer research question 2, non-parametric statistical techniques were also used to compare the level of trust in the robot for the 4 groups where the robot and human gender matched or mismatched. However, still no significant effects were found between groups, lending no credence to hypothesis 2 either. So these figures show the level of trust among participants in the 3 experimental conditions. Upon further inspection of the data, another observation was made. And so to illustrate, this figure compares the median rating for occupational competency to the median rating for trust in occupational competency. An ordinal logistic regression analysis was conducted to further determine how effective a predictor perceived competency was for perceived trust when also considering robot gender and participant gender. And our results indicated that for 11 of the 14 occupations, perceived competency was a highly significant predictor of perceived trust. We also asked users to identify the gender of the robot they saw in the video. The manipulation of the robot was successful for the male and female robot conditions. However, only 15 of the 50 participants in the gender-neutral robot condition passed the robot gender manipulation check. To account for this, we excluded the participants who failed the gender manipulation check and recalculated all the findings. However, no change was observed for any of the reported results in relation to research question 1 or research question 2. Nevertheless, we recognize that a challenge in this work and a challenge for HRI in the present is the actualization of a gender-neutral or genderless robot. While this is a promising research direction, it may prove to be no easy feat when combined with human perception. Taking on the challenge, we encourage HRI researchers to critically consider the decision to manipulate gender in their social robot design. This study expanded on prior work by investigating the effect of robot gender on perceived competency and trust for 14 occupations and by including a gender-neutral robot condition. Our results show that there were no significant differences in trust when robot gender matched the occupation's gender or when the robot's gender matched the participant's gender. These results were consistent when we excluded participants who failed to perceive the correct robot gender identity. However, this study did reveal that perceived competency was a significantly better predictor of perceived trust than robot gender or participant gender for 11 of the 14 highlighted occupations. Our findings further support other literature in the field, suggesting that performance factors are more influential on user trust than appearance factors, and calls into question the use of gendering as a technique to manipulate trust. So when you're designing your next HRI study and are considering your robot's appearance or name or voice, we encourage you to take a moment and ask, Why should we gender? I would like to thank the listed funding organization for supporting this research, along with my collaborators for all their contributions. And thank you for listening.